What does the USA do better than other countries? Acronyms. Just look at the USA Patriot Act, or Uniting and Strengthening America, by providing appropriate tools required to intercept and obstruct terrorism. Stealth planes. Since the 70s, the US has developed 4 iterations of stealth aircraft, the F-117, the B-2, the F-22, and the F-35. In the same period, the European military-industrial complex has further refined the fourth-generation fighter concept. Russia has designed a single half-assed prototype, and China has put together a few different airframes trying out a few different stealthy techniques, but nothing completely integrated yet. Find the best things from other countries and embrace them, if in a cookie or twisted way. An American can eat tacos while singing karaoke on street Patrick's Day and feel like they've had a red, white and blue good time. France has to rename Big Macs. Extremes. The nicest slash most humble and rudest slash most arrogant people I've ever met are, in both cases, Americans. By far, most foreigners I've run into fall somewhere in between. And the same goes for weight. Most obese, most skeletal, most fit, all been Americans in my experience. Edit, since I realize it slipped my mind, some of the dumbest and some of the smartest that I have personally met have been Americans. Sandwiches. All of the best sandwiches were invented and perfected in the United States. This is due to having the widest variety of sandwich ingredients, due to size, and the whole great melting pot thing, and the willingness to put anything edible between 2 carbs to see what sticks. Edit, where does it say in this post that the first sandwich was invented in America? Because I didn't type what some of y'all are finding. Grocery store variety. No other country that I've been to has grocery stores that compare to American stores in terms of sheer quantity and variety. I've seen grocery stores where the quality is higher, or where you can find things that you wouldn't in American grocery stores, but they don't touch the variety. Most of the things I need to make any type of cuisine are not only readily available, but I can usually pick between several brands. Occasionally, there will be some vegetable or spice that isn't available at my local grocery store, so I drive an extra 10 minutes to go to the farmer's market that has a more international selection. Absolute worst case, I may need to drive to a specialty store. Since my family is originally from India, we make a trip out to the Indian store every few months, but really there's only a few things that are available there exclusively. Now granted, I live in a large city and that certainly helps. But I think even small town US grocery stores have greater variety than their foreign counterparts. The First Amendment. My country, Australia, has traditionally held freedom of speech in high regard. It's a vital part of any functional democracy after all. But free speech is not written into our constitution. The only things protecting it are a number of high court rulings and the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. In the past it didn't matter, free speech was just a universally accepted part of society, but in this day and age freedom of speech is being threatened, and the arguably weak protections my country has just aren't enough. From my understanding the situation is similar in the UK, Canada and New Zealand. I think America has the right idea with the First Amendment and just their well-protected rights in general. Confidence. There's a reason that the type of impossible rags-to-riches story is branded as the American dream, because by and large, the people most likely to follow that dream and believe in its achievability are American. The creation of the country in and of itself was an impossibility given their opponent in the Revolutionary War, and yet they succeeded. I don't remember the exact quote, but a general in the early days of the country said, "A British soldier will do what you tell him. An American will as well, but he will first want to know why you told him to do it." That sort of confidence to challenge authority in such a brazen manner is intrinsic to the nation and its people, and it's unlike any other national identity on the planet. Oh, and chain restaurants. Americans themselves. Seriously though, going to the US is amazing. People are open and nice, and won't hesitate to chat up strangers. They seem genuinely interested in who you are and where you're from. I could write a book about all the things wrong with the US, but despite all that it remains my favorite place to visit due to the way they treat foreigners. There's no other country quite like it. I think the Constitution is an amazing piece of work. Sure, Some parts could have been more clearly written, but as a living document, it's pretty amazing. It's basically instructions on creating a government. It's unfortunate that the two-party system evolved out of it, and some of the rules basically inevitably led to only two parties, because more than two parties makes it difficult to reach some of the minimum vote requirements. But aside from that, it's pretty amazing. Hats off to those forefather guys. The United States tends to recognize, reward, and encourage excellence better than any other country or culture I can think of. Americans, as individuals and as a nation, do not apologize for winning or being the best. They will heap glory on it and gloat without reservation or hesitation. And if they think someone else is better than them, they will work their ass off to become better. This comment is from a Canadian. End communication. High income professions. Not that they don't exist in similar quantities in Europe or Asia, but the sheer amount of income you can make as a doctor, lawyer, engineer, or businessman in the United States is absurd. I have a relative that's a senior partner at a huge international law firm, and he says that his colleagues in the UK and the Netherlands with the same title make pitiful salaries for the same work, even after adjusting for the cost of living and exchange rate. Add on to that the very corporate-friendly and, as of now, high-income-friendly tax laws. America probably isn't the best place to be poor, but I'd argue it's one of the best places to be rich by far. Hotel rooms. I have flown all over the world during the last 30 years and while I have stayed in some really nice 5-star hotels and resorts internationally, most non-luxury hotels in the rest of the world would be considered worse than our economy hotels. Very small rooms with tiny beds with only a comforter and a thin single pillow, and no microwave refrigerator. You are very lucky if the hotel has air conditioning, or even a fan. Most only have enclosed showers that are so small you barely turn around in them. Yet in most hotels in the United States you get a room with two queen beds with sheets, blankets, at least two pillows per bed and a comforter, air conditioning, a small refrigerator, a microwave, and usually free Wi-Fi that is actually fast enough to be useful. You get all of this in our cheap hotels, usually with a breakfast buffet included. If you wanted similar rooms internationally, you would likely be paying much more for them. It's not something that the USA does, but the USA covers some of the most amazing geography in the world. The addition of Hawaii and Alaska expand on this, but you get Florida, Everglades, Colorado, and Vermont, mountains, vast flat prairies, all Atlantic and Pacific, and Arctic, coastlines, snow, sun, beaches, mountains, Grand Canyons, geysers, volcanoes, deserts, redwood rainforests, Great Lakes, so much more, all in one country. I mean, it's really remarkable, and so few Americans take advantage of this. This adds on another thing that Americans do better: traveling by RV across the country. For one thing, no passports needed. Two overlooked things that don't get enough attention when this question gets posted: curing illness and keeping the sea safe. America is damn good at launching programs to eradicate diseases both domestically and globally. Every country pitches in, but America carries the heavy gloves in the fight. America has a big-ass navy, third biggest by count. But with that navy, we keep many strategic points clear for trade. If the American navy left the ocean alone and returned to port, it would be chaos. It is like removing a traffic cop from a busy intersection. There would be a lot more incidents. People don't like America to police the world, but the Navy does keep the peace at sea, usually, which allows for amazing open trade between nations. They are not without flaw, but amo, there is no better option in the foreseeable future. Non-American here, but I can tell you what Americans do better than anyone else. Hard work. You can have the highest IQ in the land, but without hard work, it isn't worth shit. All the Americans I have worked with work harder than anyone else in the room. Movies portray them as lazy, but that's just a small percentage of the people. Thinking about the greater good, even the messiest eaters clean up after themselves. That's because they care about the next person using the table. They always follow traffic rules. Obviously there are exceptions, but the average American is attentive about their surroundings. It's easy to think it's because they have stronger law enforcement. But understand that following the rules has to come from within. They don't give a fuck, and the system supports them. American, I want to make a better mop system, please do. But I have to warn you, there are many people doing the same thing. American, I don't give a fuck. I'm going to do it, because this is how I think a mop should be. As European, I think Americans can do better than anyone these stuff. Don't have any problem with clothes, they dress what they really want, they're free. Europeans are obsessive to dress well, and they don't understand the comfort of large pants and t-shirts like Americans. Barbeque, I know it's weird, but Americans have a pretty unique school about smoking, and grill great meat. Americans are the last Westerns to love, hate and have passion about politics. Just give a look to their spectacular elections days. In Europe we are like zombies. Preserve a country or rural side. Yes, I know in Europe with wines, farmers etc, but something is changing, and is just business now. For many Americans, countryside is a lifestyle, freedom, a ranch and cowboy spirit. Jokes, friendly behavior. Many Americans have a light way to talk like kids. They are spontaneous and enjoy small life things like a dog, kids, video games. In Europe we are too disciplined and serious to open ourselves like them.